Hello my internet friends, welcome back to our discussion. I am Somnath and you are watching App on Cloud RESTful Application Programming Model Unmanaged Scenario. So if you are coming to this channel for the first time, my request would be please subscribe this channel and set the bell icon so that you should not miss any future releases. And this topic we already started in last tutorial from, which is a part 4. We created a lot of artifacts, development artifacts, like a lot of VDM models, behavioral definitions, implementations, a lot of metadata extensions, right? So you need to stick around to this discussion till the end. Why? Because I'll be taking you up certain key aspects of the ABAP on cloud programming model, right? Because the development approach in ABAP on cloud is not as we do in the on-premise for the day-to-day activities. So little bit of changes you will able to see. So you have to keep focus and stay tuned so that you get to know and don't miss out any critical information that I'm going to share through this tutorial. Okay, so let's start. Before I start part 5 with more detail about CRUD capabilities, my request would be just take a look of the previous tutorial. You can just click on the I button is showing above, and it will take you to the previous tutorials where I demonstrated the unmanaged scenario from scratch, kind of CDS build up all the way through different behavioral definition attachment, implementing those behavioral definitions. I didn't actually put any codes over there, which I'm going to do in this tutorial. What kind of a placeholder I created, we projected those behavioral definitions, right? We created consumption views. So many development artifacts that we created, and eventually we previewed the application from the Eclipse application itself. So if you just check those videos first and then come to this discussion, I think it will be more meaningful and you'll be able to easily follow the discussion. So let's start. So we created this service binding, and if we just launch this application, we'll see this transactional app working without any issues, right? It's having all the data, read operations is working pretty well. But if I click on the create and add certain data, let's say any agency or maybe any customer, and just randomly I'm giving some inputs just to tell you like what happens if I just give certain values and USD comment, let's say just travel or vacation, whatever. So if I just do it, it says object got created, but actually no number generated, right? So this is not our expectation. This is happening because we didn't implement the behavioral implementation, which we created a placeholder, as I told. Okay, so let's go to that piece of code which we did last time. Definitely you can recall. So this is the empty class that framework generated, where we have to implement in the local section. You can pretty well relate, like this create, delete, update should be responsible for this CRUD capabilities. For the time being, just park the other methods because I don't want to do all things in one go. It will be creating confusions, that I believe. So let's pretty much today try to create the travel data and subsequent booking details or booking records. Okay, so that pretty much will be focusing in this tutorial. Request would be to continue till the end of the discussion and not just skip around, so that you should not miss any key elements that I am going to cover. Okay, so if you click on this create, before even I go to that implementation, let's figure out like what the interface or kind of an importing or exporting parameters, right, this method is attached to it. You see that entities is only the importing parameter, and create for travel. For the delete, you need the keys, right? To delete the any particular travel records, you need the keys, and that's for delete. And for the update, again, it's passing the entities, but this time for update. So you see, it's different than what normal on-premise codes generally is having. It's all kind of a very generic name conventions been followed. But as I told last time, like currently, whatever the framework generated codes you can see, it was not in the previous version. So good that we are dealing with the current topic and current code base. So if you go to this create method now, click on F3, it will take you to the create section. So we have to just, you know, read these entities, which will be having my travel record, and subsequently we'll be creating the travel data and we'll save the document. That is our intention. Okay, so I'm just looping through these entities, right? I'm just assigning to a fill symbol in loop. I'm just giving any name like travel, you know, entity, right? So this is I'm going to do, and here you can ask like, are we going to create the multiple travels together? No, of course we could do our read operations also, but for the time being, keep it loop, because we have some future topic, there might be this loop will be useful. We'll figure it out later on. Okay, just stick around to this current thing, like we are just looping on the entities, and I'll just read out the travel instance information. Let's activate it and see what this entities is, you know, bringing us to this method. That will be important to understand. Okay, so I'm just double click. You can right click here. There is something called toggle breakpoint. Okay, so if you just click on toggle breakpoint, breakpoint will be off, or if you just double click, it will be active like that. So you can in pretty well can debug the cloud based code here from in within Eclipse also. Okay, only your perspective will be debug perspective, that will figure out. Okay, so it will be a debug perspective that we have to check. So let's again try out with a create operation. So let's create. I am just adding some dummy data, any records, any whatever values, put something USD, and let's say something travel, some comment. Okay, if I click on save, I'm expecting, yes, the debug perspective should get auto opened. Yes, and if you double click on this entities, you'll see this entity has few elements which we can recall, like travel agency, everything we can recall because from the part 4 tutorial, part 4, right? But you see something new you can, you know, observe, like percent CID, which is having a default value of saddle CID 1. Also at the end, you can see something called control parameter, right? Control record, percent control, and it's also having the same structure that we have the main travel table. So what this CID is, so it's kind of a context ID that framework is actually giving a dummy value, and the travel ID is currently empty or null or initial, whatever you want to call it about. And control records is actually depicting like the places or the, you know, fields that we have changed. Let's little bit take this side, hopefully it's visible to you. All the fields coming as 01, customer ID we didn't put anything by mistake, I believe. Let's go back. Yes, customer ID looks like pretty empty, and all the data currently showing in this fashion been modified is coming as 01. If not, it's become 00. So that's kind of a control parameter which will be very useful to understand like what are the fields been modified and how to deal with those data content. Kind of a control parameter, okay, that you can resemble with the BAPI control structure, right? Okay, so that's we are going to get. But what exactly after, so if I get the data, I'm creating a travel record and travel data, but we have to send the information back to the UI. So how we are going to send back the details to the UI, right, after my method is over? Because we don't have any export parameter. So for that, there is a global, kind of a lexical scope or global scope. If you just double click on that, something called mapped. Okay, so this mapped comes, and this mapped is basically having two entities, whichever we created initially, right? That means both my travel route and the booking child. So if I have more than all subsequent any sub elements, that will also be a part of this mapped structure. Okay, so this mapped is basically a globally accessible one which we'll be using to pass back the data content once we are done with it. Okay, very interesting, I should say, because this has not been quite similar the way we do in our normal ABAP programming. All right, okay, so let's execute because we need to write the codes now. And let's come back to our ABAP perspective. Our code snippet, we can just paste it over here. Anyway, I'll just give those code pieces into the Git repository so that you can just copy and take a reference if you want. But anyway, this is quite simple code. I'm just looping through the iterations. I'm just getting a corresponding mapping, and here is the good thing, like I'm using this syntax mapping from entity using control, so that you can understand from the control structure the values will be mapped and the corresponding field will be auto populated to this input structure. Calling an SAV delivered function module to get the travel instance, or I mean to say travel ID, in my output structure, which is ls travel out. Also the message I'm just capturing. And if no message there, I'm just passing it to the mapped travel as well. I've just explained the map few minutes back, right? So this map and travel, I'm just passing the content back. Okay, so if I just put it and just activate this code, and we'll just see whether it's working or not. So let's go and run the travel instance, relaunch this travel app, and let's put a breakpoint in case I would like to check. Let's try out. Okay, it's logged out. So let's try creating a new record, some number again, add it like this. Only this much of data I'm just want to go with. Let's click on save. Yeah, it get connected, and you see entities is having, go to variable tab, click on entities. So okay, let's double click. So you have this entity structures with all the fields populated, whichever we actually filled in, right, in the from the UI. And the control structure is defined as per whatever we have entered. So just keep debugging. We'll create the travel data. So this travel data is now, travel out is having my travel instance. I got a number 12352. Let's pull it little over here. Hope it's now visible. 12352 is my travel ID got created. And the status is as a in means kind of a new. And good to go for passing the data content because no message. So I can just insert the data into my map travel. So this CID, a context ID, is nothing but the context ID which I got from the entity, means from this field symbol, right? This one. And my travel ID is currently in my signature, from the structured importing structure is empty, but I got the number now. So in the map travel, I'll just pass it back. So let's go map travel and put F6, whatever. You see the map is now filled, and the context ID is the one which SAP framework returned, and the travel ID which the function model returned, right? So let's execute and see what happened. Yeah, the number got created, object created successfully. Perfect. So let's check whether so that means I can get this data once I click on this search, right? Selection field. If I click on enter, what happened? No data found, right? So it is simple because the data is currently still in transient state. It's not yet moved into a persistence layer. We have to save the data explicitly to the DB table, right? So we explained or discussed already one particular class which is responsible for this operation, and that is CL ABAP behavior saver, which we inherited to our local class. And we have a method called save, so we have to explicitly save the travel instance. Okay, so let's put call function, and I'm just using this function module. Let's say flight. What happened? Okay, so what the function module save, right? So this is the function module I want to use. And after saving the data, let's clean the buffer or whatever, you know, that things to make it no data inconsistency. So click on initialize. So these two function models I will use at the persistence layer, activate it and put a breakpoint to see if it at all gets called or not, right? So let's again try, because last time it didn't get created. Try once more with the create operation. You can give some data and booking ID, booking fee, let's say 100 USD, and comment, let's say okay. Click on save. So I'm expecting first it will hit my travel method, what already explained it. Let's execute. That isn't called F8, right? Not shift F8, simple. So you see now it hits the save operation. Fantastic, right? So that is the important thing. We have to ensure that data gets actually persisted. So now if I execute it, the same number, because it's an just kind of a, not a number range been used, but some sort of calculated check, what is the last number plus one kind of. So let's go back, and now you see with this selection I have the travel data got created, right? Fantastic. But this is what the travel creation part. I hope that is helpful, and if you are enjoying this video, please just give a thumbs up, and yeah, stay tuned and let me go ahead further to with the edit operations. Now quickly check the update process. So we have this update method, and we have to just write our custom logic inside this method. Let's go to our code snippet, copy the code, and we'll see like what it is doing. So let's I don't think we need it. Yes, fine. So what we are doing, similar like entities, we are just iterating through, and this time we are not, you know, using a control structure. Okay, why? Because when we are having an update operation or edit operation, that means my travel instance is already available, right? My travel number is already created. So as we know, the control structure doesn't contain the actual ID. So if I put, you know, using control, then this ls travel would have, you know, missed the travel ID. So that's why we are just copying from the entity but not from the control. We will debug it, and we'll just I'll just describe more like why the control parameter is not been used. So now this travel ID we are just taking from this entity, because this travel ID is actually filled in but not the control parameter, control structure rather. Anyway, and this one is kind of a private control structure, which you know, we have to fill it in, kind of a BAPI control parameter or control structure. Similar, like we have to just fill this one because the SAP delivered function module expects that travel X to be of that type, so that internally it can, you know, map the data field and then it can update the travel instance, and followed by the message whatever it's getting, right? So let's activate it, and I'll just quickly put a breakpoint here and just see like what's happening in the debug operation. So let's run this again. Somehow it got closed. Okay, so let's execute once more, and hopefully 12352 was the number, I guess. So that number we can identify now. I can update, but 12352, like this is the one he created, and this is the new status, right? Just now he created, and we want to update it. Okay, if I just edit and click on vacancy, let's say 1, click on save, what I'm expecting is the debug should trigger now. Yes, it is. And in the entity, we're just interested to check what's the structure contains. Now it's having a new field called CID reference, unlike in a create operation where we had percentage CID. In the edit operation, we have percentage CID underscore ref or reference. Okay, this time you see the travel ID is already filled in, and vacancy becomes vacancy 1, which we have basically updated. In the control structure, you see the travel ID field is basically null. I mean, it's kind of a, you know, the control structure you can think through. So obviously it will have either 0 or 1. That's the reason we cannot put a, you know, using a control syntax, I didn't put, otherwise this travel will not have this travel ID filled in with the value that we have received from the framework, right? So let's F8, and of course it will just update the data that I'm anticipating, because it's going to save operations, execute. And if I just now go back to our, if you now just see this, the data, it's basically modified with vacancy 1. So let's see whether it's really been populated or not, just to be a double sure, like really updated. Yes, it is. Let's persist it. Obviously, we have the save operation triggered. Now, let's do a little bit more. Let's say my mandatory thing is customer, right? And if I don't have a customer entered, how it behaves? Let's see. Means I mean to say I will not put any customer ID. If I click on now save, what happens? So again triggered. So this time I just would like to go step by step to check if message any populated or not. Yes, the function model returns a message and saying like, hey, some problem with error, right? So now this error handling we have to learn, like how we can do an error handling, right? So executing it, and of course you see like no kind of, you know, message been reported. So for that, what you need to do is I'll just put a little bit of code over here, copying this one, go to the above perspective and paste after this message. Okay, so that what being done here, the percent context ID is basically the one which will map with the CID reference, like that, because that is the edit part during update or edit options. Framework returns CID reference, right? So these two things I'm just mapping, And what next? Of course, the travel ID instance, right? Because that is the number or header value of the travel instance that we need to map with. And finally, I'm just passing this one to failed. So there are two things. For the first time, I'll just introduce this failed part. So failed travel, failed is some sort of similar like mapped. Okay, so any sort of error reporting, we have to use this failed and report it. Two things, right? So first I'm just using failed. So this failed, we have a travel as well booking. So currently the context or the problem statement is with the travel instance. So I'm just leveraging the travel particular entity from the failed structure. Okay, so I'm just intimating like this is what happened against this travel ID. And other than this travel, I don't have any option, okay, to map with. Only these two things I can map. So let's activate now, and we'll see like after placing this code, what happens, right? It's 12352, right? Let's go again, edit, remove once and click on save. Hopefully the debug. Yes, so you see an exception was raised, so that's the thing it's reporting. But out of this exception, we don't have any clarity what exactly the error message that the function model returned. So for that, I'll be using a particular class which travel application or maybe the SAP already created as a demo pack artifacts, demo class. That I'll be leveraging for my message handling. But eventually what we need to do is I'll be just using this particular class which I have just commented for the time being, just to showcase like what we need to do for error handling activities. Okay, so we just need to call this out. I just commenting the code and uncomment this portion. You see like simple handle travel message demo that SAP auxiliary class SAP has created, and it's taking that reference because in edit option or edit operations, the travel ID and the message it will return. Whatever the message I am getting, this message I'm just passing it to for the parsing of the message. And it will fill the field as well reported. So this reported is actually important. This reported one will be having more provision with the message ID, message number, etc. So let's quickly go inside that function model, sorry, the class I would say rather. You see this reported has a provision with a different message option, right? So more detailed of messaging I can pass it to the report segment. But failed only is having only CI percentage CID and travel ID, nothing else. Okay, so that is the thing that we can pass onto this failed. Now let's activate this code and relaunch or maybe retry the saving operations again. I'm closing it, go back. I'm not gonna save. Click again, edit, remove this customer ID. What you are expecting, just see whether it matches or not. You see customer zero unknown, right? So the messages whatever is returned by the function model, I mean to say this function model, right, demo flight travel date, the message, that message is being parsed inside this class and is passing the same message into the reported segment. So this is the way we can handle the error messages in the Abapon cloud programming. Okay, so hope this particular piece of edit is also helpful. Let's move forward with the delete operations now. Okay, so what next we can do? We have a delete method like create an update. So let's quickly go to delete method and implement the code over here. What we can do, we can just simply copy this particular piece, putting it over here. What the code is doing, simple, it's looping through the keys, because keys is the signature of the particular delete method. You can quickly check importing keys, like the instance IDs or the keys is actually being returned by the framework. I'm just looping it through and I'm just using the SAP delivered travel delete function module, and finally I'm just reporting any message being triggered. Okay, so that's pretty much I'm doing. Activating the code back, and I'll see like what's the results if I want to delete something. So let's go back. No. If I select from here and click on delete, will it work? Yes, I want to delete. Object deleted. But seems like the data remains here. Nothing, it doesn't look good. Any problem? Did we activate it? Of course we activated, right? So okay, just need to be sure that it's working. Let's click on go. It didn't delete actually, right? So let's select and click on delete once more. Yes, I want to. Yes, now it's, maybe I didn't activate the code before. So that's pretty much simple, the delete operations that we have done. Okay, so now we have just covered the travel instance create, update and delete operation, or CRUD operation, and we don't need the read method to be implemented, as I told earlier, because this is implicitly, it will be handled by the framework. So what I next was planning to do is create the booking instance and the booking records, but this part I will leave it to you do it by your own. Okay, it's kind of an assignment or kind of a practice things that you can try out. So I just would like to give you a small hints over here. As you know, like we are using a create of the booking as a as an association based from the travel as a route, right? So this is my route view, and this is my child booking table is my child view, right? So we are using an association, which is a special type of association, which is a composition, right? So this composition association is used, and when we'll create this booking record, we have to use an association based create approach or create technique. So for that, you have to use this particular method, CBA underscore booking. Okay, so it's a create based association booking. So this is from this travel class, local class. You can use this create based association booking method to implement and to create your booking records. And for the update and delete of the booking, this class is not sufficient for that. You have to just go to another class which we also implemented the last time. Here you will find the respective delete and update method. Okay, so there you have to write your custom logic to handle the booking deletion as well the edit operation. So this part I will take care of in the next tutorial, but before that I would like you to try and come back with any questions, any challenges that you faced, and just put on the comment line what exactly your experience you can share as, and that will be a very interactive way of learning. Okay, so just a quick wrap up what you learned. When you are having the travel creation, so this is my create method, it's having the signature as entities, which is having the percentage CID, which is the context ID, plus UI inputs, means whatever the UI entries that I'm entering, so that this entity will contain. Additionally, we'll have a control structure, right, that we have seen. And the output, it's nothing having a signature, but we know kind of a global scope, where mapped is the structure that will be auto filled in with the entities. For us, it's travel and booking. These two entities will be automatically this linked to this map structure. And we have to just ensure that context ID and entity keys, which we received through this create operation, create code, that we have to pass it on to the respective entity, either travel or booking, depending on the implementation class. And when we are going for an update, that time we are having a different thing. It's not a CID, rather CID underscore reference, similar like UI input as well the control structure. It will come to the my update method, but this time I don't have any need any mapped tables because the mapping is already done. It's already existing, right? And because I'm just editing the instance, so instance already mapped with this travel and booking, so no need to worry about. Just change, just use the SAP function model to update the database persistence layer. That is all pretty much will be done automatically with that. A transient layer also we don't need to explicitly take care of this mapping part in the update operation. That's you have already seen, right? And error handling, we have two things, failed and reported. For the failed, we'll have the percentage CID and the entity keys, right? So in our case, it's a travel ID and the CID was there for the failed, whereas for the reported, we'll have the percentage keys, percentage CID and the entity keys, right? So these reported things will be required when we need to message out to the US screen. So that's pretty much for today's discussion. I hope this discussion was fruitful and informative to you. You may share this tutorial or the link to your friends, and you can subscribe and set the bell icon as I already implemented before. And stay tuned in the next tutorial. We'll coming up with drafting, locking, and different authorization aspects. If possible, in the time permits, we'll also discuss about EML, which is entity manipulation language, something different, API creation. Okay, so stay tuned, and we'll next connect in the upcoming tutorial that I'm going to publish in the subsequent week, as I told. Till then, goodbye.